The Philippine National Police welcomes plans of Vice President Duterte to file complaints against police officers over the transfer of her Chief of Staff, Zulaika Lopez, to the Veterans Memorial Medical Center. PNP spokesperson Brigadier General Jean Fajardo says anyone has the right to file a case against the cops if they feel they were aggrieved. Duterte's threat to file cases come after the PNP launched a complaint against her for direct assault, disobedience, and grave coercion. The complaints stem from the disruption of Lopez's transfer Saturday. Duterte, for her part, is filing disobedience, kidnapping, and robbery charges over the incident.
Kakapatan naman po nila yon. Ayan naman po ay aakapin ng PNP. Hintayin po natin yung official copy po nitong mga kasong isinampa po natin nila laban sa ating kapulisan. At bibigyan din po tayo ng pagkakataon na sagutin yan. But naniniwala po tayo na yung mga naging action po ng ating kapulisan na nung nakakaang Sabado to ay ito ay bilang pagtugon na rin po sa pakiusap at request po ng House of Representatives at wala po tayong violate na anumang batas with respect po sa naging action po ng inyong PNP ng nakakaang Sabado po.
A joint Philippine House panel is seeking the custody of an alleged customs fixer, Mark Taguba, due to alleged security threats. The House Squad Committee formally wrote to the Corrections Bureau after Taguba attended the panel's Wednesday hearing. He testified on Wednesday that lawmaker Paulo Duterte and his brother-in-law, Manasseh Scarpio, were part of a so-called Davao group that smuggled 6.4 billion pesos worth of drugs in 2017. Taguba is currently detained for his role in processing that shipment. Former Senator Antonio Trillanes told lawmakers Taguba is receiving threats from some people involved in his drug charge.
The Agriculture Department approves additional fish imports due to consecutive typhoons that hit the country. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Jervis Manahan. Jervis?
Yes, Ron, the Department of Agriculture has greenlit the additional importation of small pelagic fishes like the galunggong. They will be allowing the imports of 8,280 metric tons of fishes for retail in wet markets now that the closed fishing season has commenced in the country. The Department of Agriculture says the additional imports is due to lower production of fishes after consecutive weather disturbances. Assistant Secretary Arnel De Mesa, spokesperson of the department, said the reason is the consecutive storms from Christine to Pepito and that our fish production was badly hit since many fishermen stopped fishing during the onslaught of the typhoons. He also said that right now the price of fish is still quite elevated and they are expecting that the imports will temper the retail price of certain fishes. Closed fishing seasons have started in some parts of the country, lasting until February to mid-March of 2025. During this period, commercial fishers are not allowed to fish to allow fishes in big fishing grounds to repopulate. The sanitary and phytosanitary import clearances for the additional fish import volume will be issued until December 16, and fish imported during this time must arrive in the country by January 30 of next year. A portion of the imports will go to Kadiwa stores to help indigent Filipinos get affordable source of protein. Ron.
Jervis Manahan with that story. Thanks.
There will be no major price hike for basic commodities and most Noche Buena products until the end of the year. That assurance given by the Trade and Industry Department. The trade chief says over half of the usual Noche Buena products will be priced the same as last year. The rest of the products will only increase by less than 5%.
Actually, there was no price increase since last year. So, of course, prices, some are imported products have already increased. So, they decided to request if they could increase. So, we agreed on a less than 5% increase so that at least the consumers will have, of course, a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.